Anyway, the next song is a bit of a power duo. I think that's a the light way to say
Yeah.
it. I'll let you introduce this one.
So, yeah, this is Lady Gaga and Bruno Mars, Die With a Smile. Quick intro, I guess, to it. Last time we heard Lady Gaga, actually, no, she featured on a song with Rolling Stones last year
Yeah, but
on their
before.
album.
And she actually had some songs with, oh
But
my God, what's his name? Oh my God, what's his name? He passed away not long after. Tony Bennett. She had song. She had
yeah,
a
Tony
song with
Bennett.
Tony Bennett. Maybe
No,
an
she had a whole
album.
album with him.
Yeah, she had an album with Tony
She
Bennett.
did. She had the whole album. And
Before that, it was Shallow.
then before that it was Chromatica. But as for Bruno Mars, we haven't heard him at all, I think, since An Evening with Silk Sonic.
No.
I think that was the last
He's
time we've heard
gone.
him.
He's just been
And I mean,
touring.
I was just saying to Zach earlier that like I consider that album, it's arguably my favorite album of 2021. Definitely a no skip album. So great stuff there. It's my favorite Bruno album as well. So it's interesting to see them both back and both together on a song like this because we've never seen them work together before. With
This is his
I
first
actually
song since.
said the crazy part as well is I said Lady Gaga might be my favorite female pop star of the 2010s, and Bruno might be my favorite male one. So I said you've probably got like arguably my two favorite pop stars of the decade collaborating. So I said I really hope this is something special.
My question is,
And I've heard a lot of good things.
yeah, I'm excited myself. My question is, who the fuck talked about Bruno? Because he's back. Anyway, Lady Gaga, Bruno Mars, Die With a Smile, official music video. It looks like we're getting a little bit. I'm going back, but it immediately reminds me of Silk Sonic videos. Sounds like Joji immediately. Okay, Benson Boone.
I just woke up from a dream where you and I had to say goodbye. And I don't know what it all means, but since I survived, I realized wherever you go, that's where I'll follow. Nobody's promised tomorrow.
I fucked up so bad.
So I'ma love you every night like it's the last night. Like it's the last night. If the world.
I gotta stop it, bro, because we're gonna. Yeah. Okay.
I mean,
Really
he
good so
sounds
far.
fantastic.
So good so far. But I love the tone of the guitar, too. It reminds me of Midsummer Madness and also
Then again,
the tone of
Bruno
Mina
is an
Joji.
incredible vocalist,
Yeah,
so
I expect
yep.
that. I need to say that
Everything's sounding great
I
so
made a
far. The writing's really great.
catastrophic.
It's
Yeah,
just
I'm really liking it. I made a catastrophic mistake immediately though, because the first 28 seconds I didn't even turn the fucking display on. But he had me so captured that I was just out of it, man. I didn't know what to do. When Bruno starts singing, everybody goes quiet. Everybody goes quiet. Also, come on, come on. I heard some of the Gaga songs. What the fuck you know about cameras? Sorry, I just remembered that. I was about to say Gaga, but it bothered me. What the fuck does she know about cameras? No, but smoking's not good, Miss Gaga. So the way we bring it down is cold. Banger so far.
Okay, well, this is gonna be one of the biggest hits of the year. I know it's like probably a little bit late for it to be like number one of the year on size, but I mean
It's
it's
really
gonna be
good.
massive.
It's
It's
really good. I can't
that's
judge
it's
how it's.
got it. It's got it.
I
Like when
can't judge how
if
it's gonna
I if
go,
I had
but
to say what it is, I don't know, it's just everything there. It's got it.
yes, it is.
Songwriting is incredible, his voice is incredible. The instrumentation is terrific. It's just literally everything about it. There's
My
no
God,
complaints.
you! Oh my God, give him a break! absolutely goggling. Brody's doing flips on it. Okay, sorry. No, it's good. It's really, 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 really good. Yeah, I don't have any complaints. I'm just giving it a minute to soak in. It sounds great, but if I'm being honest, I don't remember a time where I heard a Bruno Mars song and was like, he doesn't sound great, especially ballads. So, let's just continue here. I wanna be next to you. Such a weird sound, too, for Bruno Mars, that. It sounds so good with him, though.
Oh, really? It does remind me a lot of Silk Sonic.
It sounds like Silk Sonic, but the tone of the instrumental is like if you were blending Silk Sonic with Joji. It really does. And Bart, fuck off my Xbox. All right. He keeps trying to lay on top of it. If you know anything about Xbox fucking Series X, is the top. Motherfucker, did you just lift a pole? He's trying to go back already. What was I saying? Oh yeah, it reminds me of a mixture of that with the tone of the instrumental and the way it comes back down is very like Joji-esque. But I hear the Silk Sonic too. Lost in the words that we scream. I don't even want to do this anymore. 'Cause you already know what you mean to me. And all of the only war we're fighting for. Wherever you go. I have no choice. Forgive me. fucked up. I feel like an ass. I have to pause it there. I'm sorry.
It's copyright, people.
It's gonna get us copyrighted. At first she sounded a little weird. Like, I don't necessarily know about... I feel like it's one of those things that can very much... is like, at first, it's gonna be like... if it was a little off for me. Something was odd. I think it's just the really probably just... I can't place it. But it, I do feel like it's something that's going to go away. I do think that's just the first listen. I think it just caught me off guard.
Yeah.
I can't place it. It's just something to do with her voice and the production right there. Ooh, maybe she sounded further away than Bruno did. Maybe that's it. So I'ma love you every night like it's the last night. Not that Bruno can get that fucking far away from it. Cool ass shot. That glare making the rainbow between them. I have to pause. I'm sorry. I don't know what instrumental style this is. I don't know. There's some of the. I'm so getting a music degree because I'm so.
It's very jazzy. It's very jazzy. It's very like.
Here's the deal. It's jazzy.
R&B.
It's jazzy and R&B. A little bit in there. But there is. I don't know if it's the chords they're using. But it the tonality of it is what I'm telling you. It's like it is literally feels like jazz and blues, mixed with. I keep saying it. I'm beating a dead horse here, but. it not maybe directly Joji, but his sound, like even on maybe a little bit of Midsummer Madness, the song, like there's the, I think it's the
chorus. I don't hear Joji at all.
It's the, I'm trying to pinpoint what I'm saying. No, I don't hear Joji's too quiet. What I'm saying is like it, the chord progressions and the chord choices and the tone of the guitar is a Joji song. Everything else around it is totally different. So it doesn't even sound remotely the same. But the undertone of it is just like it's the same chord progressions. I could almost promise you that if I looked at the chord progressions of this song, it's in the same key. Ooh, let me continue. As maybe Glimpse of Us. Next to you. Right next to you. That sound, bro? It's so unbelievable. I'm going to pause it so we can just play it all the way out. I'm going to go back a little bit here. But, this doesn't sound like... It sounds like something Silk Sonic would make, but if I'm being totally honest, it does sound different. Like, I'm hearing the Silk Sonic in it, but it sounds so different than what I would expect either of them to ever make. Like, it completely catches me off. It doesn't sound... It's weird. Well,
no, this does fit. This is a very Bruno. This is a Bruno thing to do. Lady Gaga is where it's catching me off guard.
I know you're saying it's...
But then again, though, she's done the thing with Tony Bennett, which was obviously a throwback.
But it's not jazz I'm hearing. That's the problem. There's jazz influence in it. But it feels... It's not the same type of jazz. Bruno's was doing, like, maybe with, like you said, like, Tony Bennett type... Yeah, there's probably that more type of jazz. But, like, yes, Bruno did a little jazz. But, like, it really wasn't jazz as much as it was, like, R&B and a blend of that. It was more... It was a
mix of jazz and 70s like, R&B. The idea.
Well, jazz is low tone. It's very, like... It's I really need to improve my vocabulary musically because I'm really having an issue just trying to describe what I'm saying. I'm just gonna... It's a waste of time. Okay, okay. It's just very unique. Even the melodies. That part specifically. And these little notes. What song? Even the lyric. Yeah, there's a song that reminds me of too. I can't pinpoint it though. But, and that might be what I'm hearing is that similarity to another song. I'll figure that out every time. Song was fucking incredible. Is an understatement. It's real.
And I remember seeing someone say, like, love songs are back.
Oh,
like,
false.
Like, it's been a while since we've had.
False. It is not a Bruno Mars song. Bruno Mars is not back. Lady Gaga's back. It isn't Bruno. It's Lady Gaga's song. just clocked that. It's all
not. It's both of theirs, but it's just her channel. But
yeah, but that means it's not a single. So maybe it could be.
I'd assume it is, unless he's going for some sort of thing. But it looks like it's a single.
It's not a single for his album. I'm saying I don't think it's a single for his.
No, it doesn't look like a single for any album. It might just be an off single. It looks to be marketed as one.
Yeah.
But, I mean, either way.
Good as fuck.
Incredible stuff. As I said, I saw a comment saying, like, that love songs are back. That, like, it's the best love song we've had in a while. And, yeah, I think that's fair. Like, you look at, like, how many love songs there are, and it's sort of like, I do get the sense that a lot of love songs are kind of fading a little bit, you know?
Yeah, they are.
Like, a lot of it's usually like, pop overly songs sexualized. Now have gone from, like... Yeah, it's usually just Needless Six now.
But here's the deal. On a broad scale of things, right? And that's why I keep fucking with this. I just keep bored and finicking with it. Or fidgeting with it. But, like, a lot of songs, right? Like, on the mainstream, like, obviously, if you look at, like, you stand back and you're like, okay, there's... This number one hit, this number one, this number one hit, this number one hit, right? But there are actually a lot of still good love songs. It's just that the majority of what's pushed, what's promoted, and what's working is just overly sexualized garbage. And even the good songs some of the times are still overly sexualized. The movie industry, everything we can both agree, literally everything's over-sexualized. Nothing's very lovey-dovey anymore or romantic. And this song feels very lovey-dovey and romantic. So I like it a lot, but there are a few other ones.
And the good thing is, as well, is Ever Been by Bebe and you can tell from the video
of a good love song.
You can tell from the video as well that both of them have a lot of charisma. Both of them are able to sell love songs. Both of them have made love songs before that worked perfectly. Like, actually, I'm pretty sure if I come to think of it, my favorite song from both of them is probably I mean, I know Lady Gaga's is my favorite song from her, but Bruno, I mean. He's got songs like Marry You, for example.
I couldn't tell you my favorite love song.
Just the Way You Are.
If I'm being real.
There was When I Was Your Man, which was a breakup one, but still. I mean, some terrific stuff there.
It's a reminder. Don't worry about that. I need to talk to you after the video about something I forgot to say. I just don't want to say on the video.
But
and you're gonna say
no. Something. Loved everything about it.
Loved it.
We should probably do a solo outro.
Yeah. If you guys like this video, leave a like on the video. Let's get to 100 likes. Okay. That'd be kind of cool. Leave a comment on this video and tell us what you thought about the song or recommend another song. But realistically, just tell us what you thought about this one. Subscribe. We're almost to 1,000. It's a huge goal of ours, and we're really getting close. We've been going for a long time, and looking forward to that goal. So if you guys want to help us out, we'd love you to. We'd love you to stick around. We also have these two remixes we did, this Toby remix behind me, as well as this Houdini remix behind me. Trying to get both of those to 1,000 views, which is a little bit easier than 1,000 likes on this video.
Down in the description below. Especially Toby. Go listen to Toby, because Houdini's doing well on its own. Toby is not.
Yeah. Go check
help Toby out. It's struggling.
Toby's having a hard time. You know, first his girlfriend, you know, now this. That's spoiled. All right, let's move on. okay. Best and worst. I'll go first this week. I think you went first last week.
Well, you just meant to say goodbye. It was meant to say goodbye. Shit. We're halfway through a solo outro. What are you doing?
I got zoned out. You act like it matters. No one's fucking watching this anyway. Thank you guys for watching, Dylan. This is where you say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye, fellas.